Hello, my beautiful gaming community. Talking Gamer of Advanced Arcade here. I hope you're doing well. Welcome to Advanced Arcade's first ever Top 10 Ceremony. The topic of today's ceremony is Super Smash Brothers! As you probably know, what around the world will know is that the Smash for Switch is very likely to be announced at E3 2017. In anticipation of this, Johnny Boy and I have prepared a list of our top 10 first-party characters we'd love to see in Smash. And now, let's get into it.
I'll never make a Smash character wish list that doesn't feature... Well, first party anyways, that doesn't feature Isaac from Golden Sun. I feel so passionately for this character. I feel that he's gypped. I think he deserved a role or a spot in this roster since at least his first game came out. And he hasn't got it. The love he got most recently was a soundtrack from this game. A soundtrack. They scrapped him as an assist trophy, which was, you know, obviously not what most people who wanted him in the game wanted, but hey, at least we could see him there. They took him away and just put in the soundtrack. Well, that's darn near disrespectful. Please put him in. His moveset potential is beautiful. He's not an assist trophy anymore, so it's... You can easily put him in there, give him a little redesign, freshen him up a bit, or spray some perfume on him, make him look nice and pretty. Go ahead and put him in there so that we can scream and our quake in our trousers.
My interest in this character becoming a playable fighter rose when I saw this trophy in Smash 4. A fast character who dominates the field from the back of his motorcycle of power. I know what most of you are thinking.
What moveset could some 8-bit biker possibly have?
Worry not. I put some thought into it and I'm happy to share. As his up special, a small ramp will appear just in front of him as he revs up his bike. The longer you hold it, the higher and steeper the ramp will get. Release the B button to boost up the ramp. Be careful. If you hold it too long, you'll overheat and probably fall to your death. Cast a puddle of mud on the ground in front of you with your neutral special, causing any foes who walk over it to trip and take light damage. Hold your side special to charge up a powerful forward Lilith dash attack, but if you hold too long, you run that risk of overheating again. Now for the down special. This wasn't my original idea, but I like it. An intentional overheat. There would be a short charge before the overheat, but if you time it right and are close enough to your opponent, it will send them flying. It's kind of like a combination of Jigglypuff's Sleep and Captain Falcon's Falcon Punch. Overheating will always have this effect on enemies close enough to you, but the cooldown of one could spell your doom, so time your moves carefully. Finally, this final smash can be a bigger, more powerful version of the assist trophy function.
Hopefully, going through a possible moveset for him could boost his chances of actually getting in. I know he's been considered to be a fighter before, but I think Sakurai struggled with coming up with a moveset for him, and so the idea was scrapped. But hopefully this can give him a better chance.
Takamaru is originally from an exclusive Japanese NES title. He's a great character, and he has very high potential in the Smash universe. I think he was considered for Smash 4, but later scrapped. I don't know why he was scrapped, I guess due to popularity, but if you ask me, that's no excuse. Roy and Marth both got in, and Ness also. They all got into Smash before that, and they were just Japanese exclusive characters. They rose in popularity because of Smash, and now Fire Emblem is one of the most popular Nintendo franchises in North America, and we've seen I've seen some love for Earthbound recently on the virtual console. So I think you should add Takamaru to the roster, not just as an assist trophy, as a playable fighter character, so that he can get some loving over here in North America. Maybe we can bring his franchise back, because he'd be a strong fighter, he'd have good projectiles, and he'd be amazing.
I feel that a spot for them is darn near guaranteed. The Inklings definitely earned their place on the roster. They are active proof that Nintendo still got it. And with Splatoon 2 right around the corner, what better way to promote it than to feature the Inklings as fighters in one of Nintendo's greatest franchises? As for a moveset, up B would obviously be the Super Jump. Side B would be the Ink Grenade. Able to hit an opponent, make them flinch, wait a little bit, and then explode on its own. Their down special could be the Ink Roller, slamming it down, running a few steps forward, and then swinging it back upwards, causing for a powerful combo attack, but also leaves you wide open if you miss. The neutral special would be the Charger. Hold it down to charge it all the way, then roll out of it, and you can save it. And whenever you push the B button again, it'll send a quick, precise, powerful blast directly in front of you. And obviously, well, not obviously, but finally for their final smash, it could be any number of the special moves in the game. The Kraken, the Ink Tornado, anything. Any one of those would fit the game perfectly.
Of course, I'm going to have the Joneser on my list. If there's any games that resonated well with me from the NES era, it was definitely Star Tropics. It's a dungeon crawler similar to Zelda, but it's much different. You have overworlds and everything is different in the overworld, and then whenever you enter a dungeon, everything changes. And every time you enter a dungeon, you have a blank slate. And it's your job to find the items within the dungeon to use to beat the bosses and, you know, obviously beat the dungeon. There's so many different items to pick up. The potential for a moveset for Mike Jones is incredible. And I feel like it's a very underrated series, even though it had a sequel that was also pretty amazing. And it was also one of the last games for the NES released, behind Wario's Woods. So I feel like this is definitely a game that could come back if it saw the popularity that it deserves, which there's no better opportunity for that than to feature him as a playable fighter in Smash Bros. Vaadi is the second most recurring villain of the Zelda universe, right behind Ganondorf / Ganon himself. Vaadi usually finds himself as the villain of the 2D games, not all of them, but a few of them. And he has a great backstory. He's loved within the Zelda community. He's powerful. He can transform as Final Smash. He's a wind mage. He's a Minish. There's so much that you can do with Vaadi. Also, he could serve as the direct villain counterpart to Toon Link. Obviously, you have regular Link and Ganondorf. You can have Toon Link and Vaadi face off against each other. Obviously, you can face anyone, but that's how I would see it. I like the look of it. I think Vaadi needs some representation. He was a great villain with a great story, and I feel like he kind of got swept under the rug. So, yeah. Hashtag free Vaadi. My idea for Black Shadow was a long shot, but I would love nothing more for this to happen. I think F-Zero does deserve more representation. I think more villains need to be featured in this game. And I also feel like Ganondorf needs a moveset that resembles more of who he actually is in the Legend of Zelda franchise. So, I propose adding Black Shadow to the roster, giving him Ganondorf's old moveset, because let's face it, a clone of Captain Falcon that's slower, stronger, and has a shadow aura around all of his attacks definitely fits the villain of the F-Zero franchise way more than Ganondorf. So people who main Ganon can just move on to Black Shadow and still have their character. Zero can get more representation, there could be another villain, and Ganondorf can be remodded to have a moveset that fits his actual character. You know, dual-wielding swords, levitation, magic balls of energy, that sort of deal. Silix is, in my opinion, the best choice as another Metroid representative, especially on the more villainish side. Ridley, let's face it, is too big. I know I'm gonna get hate on that, but even if he's just too big. He's already been introduced in the Smash universe as big, and I know Bowser did too, but technically that was just Giga Bowser that you were fighting that was really huge. And I mean, Giga Bowser is too big to be a Blazing Man. I don't disagree with that. That's why he's just a final Smash. Anyways, Silix, though, is known to hate both Samus and the Federation, and I don't think anyone knows why yet. And I think the makers of Metroid even said that they're thinking about making a game, probably Metroid Prime 4, that's going to delve into that, his hatred for Samus and the Federation, and the relationship between him and Samus. And so, he was also teased after the credits of Federation Force. So I feel like something's going to happen with Silix really soon. I feel like he's important enough, and the fact that he hates Samus, all of this is reasons. Oh, also, he's normal sized. That's he's a normal size, and he can actually square off against Samus, and he looks cool. So yeah, I think if there's going to be any other Metroid representation, which there should be, especially on the villain side, it should be Silix. Karate Joe, a representative for the Rhythm Heaven franchise, Nintendo's star rhythm game. I feel that this game, along with rhythm games in general, definitely deserve a representative in the Smash Bros. Community, because there isn't one yet. And if there were going to be one, I feel that Karate Joe would definitely be the best choice to go with. People say the choir kids, but honestly, what can they do? I feel that there's nothing that they can do to, like, fight. Plus, there's three of them, so it'd just be way too much. But Karate Joe himself is already a fighter, and then I feel his moves can definitely be incorporated into a moveset very easily. So definitely put him in as a brawler, and I'd be picking him up for sure.
Five years ago, I would have called you crazy for putting this guy on your list, but now he has risen to the top of my list with his balloons of guidance. Forget Villager's recovery, that could be changed with ease, I'm sure. I love that he's from the 8-bit era, and when I thought about his moveset, I found myself wanting to main the Balloon Fighter. Allow me to illustrate. Balloon Fighter with his balloons would have multiple jumps and be able to glide by holding down the jump button. His up special would spawn a baddie from his game beneath his feet so he can bounce off their balloons for some extra height. The baddie would then spiral downward and spike any opponents who touch it. Getting hit in the air will pop one of your balloons, but don't fret. Repeatedly tap your neutral special to inflate your balloons. Summon the dreaded fish in front of your current location to take a bite out of your foe. Be careful though, this move could leave you wide open. Place a stationary spark with your side special to obstruct a pursuing foe for a set period of time. Tap B again before it disappears to send it slowly bouncing forward around the stage for a short duration. At long last, the final smash. Balloon trip, of course. A barrage of sparks sweep the stage from left to right, damaging and carrying challengers to their demise. You couldn't stop me from playing as this character. Plus, his overall design fits the world of Smash.
Well, the results are in. Now to announce the third, second, and first prize winner of this ceremony. Coming in third place, we have
now for the runner-up. We have... This is it, folks. The moment you've all been waiting for. Our first place champion is...